Hello everybody and welcome back to FTB Inventions. We are back here in the world, and like I said, I mean, before, if you haven't seen my update video and the t-shirt contest video, make sure you check that out. I go into depth a little bit more about, you know, me and some of that type of stuff, and, you know, I got the webcam up there and stuff like that. The webcam thing, we'll see. We'll see how that works out. I've been doing a lot of testing lately. And, well, certain things I like, certain things I don't, and it gets a little bit frustrating. So I'm going to keep testing. I'm actually going to be changing my entire setup here, hopefully in the next week as well, for streaming and recording, using an additional CPU to run it all, which should improve my overall performance as well, which is great. But yeah, so anyways, we did a little live stream of Minecraft on my birthday last week, last Tuesday, June 21st, and I built some of this stuff here, and we moved over our storage from our other place, and we rearranged the growth accelerator and kind of semi-automated that a little bit, as well as we made a whole bunch of inscribers and automated up that. And as you can see in this drawer, this is my buffer drawer for my processors. We have 8 stacks. Yeah. 8 stacks to 64. And then, of course, we also have a backlog, which is great because this is the type of thing that I want to have. Now, this is probably too much of that, but that's fine. But this is the type of thing that I always want to have on hand. After the video, I logged in the next day and I hated all of this design. It's terribly done. I don't know, maybe I was tired or something, but it's just really not good. So I'm probably going to redo all of that. We used a little bit of the Ender IO ME conduits, which are pretty cool because you can include them in the same block as your standard Ender IO. So when it comes to this stuff, you still get the power to the systems, but they go in with the item conduits and whatnot as well. So that's great. Over here, we have an ME interface keeping 3 redstone available at all times. And this guy's just pulling out redstone to place into these 3 completed systems. All right. Pretty straightforward there. Nothing too crazy. But yeah, this is terribly wired, terribly designed. We're going to redo the whole thing at some point in time. I might do it on a live stream. I might just do it off camera. We'll see what happens there. pardon me, I got like a froggy in my throat or something. over here, I've started putting a few storage buses on some of the more important things that I needed, like gold for the logic, diamonds for the engineering, and then iron, because iron's used in so many recipes. I would like to get, I think I'm going to switch to drawers, just because then it's only one storage bus on the drawer controller, and you have access to everything. I do think I'm going to switch to that. We might even do that today. We'll see for our bulk storage, or eventually we'll probably go straight deep storage unit anyways. So for all this stuff, mind you, we're not going to have that much stuff because we're just basically using blaze rods as exchange value. So yeah, I'm not going to be too worried. And most of the stuff we can get. I'm sorry, I have like a tickle in my throat or something. I might have to pause and take a beverage. Over here, we did the growth accelerators as well. Redid them, I should say, with some water right up here. Pretty straightforward. But the only thing that we added in was the vacuum chest with a filter for pure certus and pure fluix, and a range of 3 on the whitelist. So basically what it'll do is if we have some seeds in here growing, once they grow, this chest automatically will pick them up, which is great for us. So we don't have to worry about being nearby or anything like that. And then we just have an import bus to put it back into our system. Speaking of our system, we do have, we got stuff in there now. We have some stuff, but you know, like having 512 processors, that's good for later game especially. So, you know, that's one of the things that I'm considering. The other thing, so we have some goods in here. We got some redstone in here. What? I don't think that's supposed to be in there. That's supposed to be in the barrel downstairs, isn't it? I'm pretty sure. Because I'm pretty sure we don't have that storage bust. Oh, no, we do. Oh, we do. Never mind. It's fine. It's fine. No big deal. Don't. No need to panic. But yeah, so that's kind of what we did a little bit. You know, just kind of talked and whatnot as well. I started expanding on the pathway around the central point here, or the central hub. I'm probably going to put another crafting terminal over here, I've decided, just to have. And then we are going to keep... We probably won't keep these workshop tables down the road because there's not really going to be a need. And yeah, so we did a decent amount of stuff. Now, I want to get going on autocrafting. Yeah, so with Applied Energistics, you can set up things to automatically craft, and you can set up craftables that you can click and craft. Now, I've been really a big component of like the click to crafting all the time, and I think, like I said last episode, I want to try to do a lot of automated stuff where we just have a certain amount in storage all the time, similar to what we did with the processors there. So the first thing that we're going to need for this is we're going to need a crafting unit or crafting setup here. So I think, well, let's see. Yeah, that's pretty straightforward. Okay. Let's take a look and get some of this done. So the crafting units themselves, because we need that for all of these, it's true. Okay, good. So we'll make a few of these. Oh, we don't have any ME cables, really. Oh boy. Oh boy. We're out of quartz fiber as well. There we go. Let's get some of that going. We should, glass is easy for us to get. It's one of the things that we can do. That quartz fiber, though, is a little bit of a different story. Boom. Okay, we'll get some of this. Just a few for right now. And we'll get ourselves a couple crafting units. Now, I think to start out, how many can we make? See, having these processors available, look at that. Right, we just were able to make 9 of those without having to really worry about needing additional processors. That's kind of a big deal for me. Definitely not something that I was used to. And then same with this. So we can now get some crafting co-processing units. I usually like to go with 6. I don't know if there's a specific awesome amount or anything like that that you should strive for, but you know, it's one of those things. Let's see, for the 64K, how many do we need? So we need 3 of these, which involves 3 of these. So that's 9 of these, which involves 3 of those. It's 27 1Ks, is that right? So we'll do 27 1Ks, which if you consider, like 27 1K to get a 64K is actually a pretty good deal. But again, we have all the processors ready to go for us, so we can just craft all the things. It's wonderful. We probably will need more quartz glass. Oh, no, we had enough. Perfect. Just enough. Just enough. And now we need more. Okay. So we need to get more dust overall. So let's get some Certus. We'll pull it out of our system here. And actually, you know what? Let's go back to the other base. We still have all of our machines over here. I haven't set up a machine room yet. But my machine room, I want to be almost 100%... automatic. I want to have every small little detail automatically given to us that we're going to use quite often. Ooh, birthday cakes. Yeah, we did that too. Yeah, we did. All right. Now, a lot of people have been commenting in, you know, the FTB1 group and stuff about no mobs spawning in the world. I do not have the same problem over here. Not at all. We have plenty of mobs. So I'm not sure if it's something in their particular area that's causing grief or what, but yeah, that's not an issue here at all. Okay, good. Give me the loot. All right, we got the blaze rods. We can throw these in here, just like so. I saw you. You're dead. All right, so we'll throw those in there. Good. And what was I going to get? Certus, right? Boom. We'll just pull out a few of these because we're going to need them. And I'm just going to start pulverizing them up here. We'll get the Certus quartz dust that we need. I should actually take some of this stuff over with me as well as we start Well, you know what? These can stay. Yeah, those can stay. But, yeah. So we'll take some of that stuff over as we get going. Our reactant dynamos over here are working great. I did switch to this system. I can't remember. I don't think I did this on camera or not. I can't remember. But we do have reactant dynamo set up using up some of that mob essence with blaze powder. And then I just set up a macerator to automatically do the thing from the deep storage unit here of blaze rods. So it'll automatically grind up some blaze powder and put it in as required. Pretty easy and slick system overall, if I do say so myself. The burning you guys are hearing is still the blaze downstairs. These are all still working great. I need to build a lot more over there to move all of this stuff over. I need a machine dome and I need some mob domes for the other stuff. So we'll just head on back over here with what we have and hopefully, oh, it's so wonderful. Load in. Thank you. Silly game, Minecraft. Silly game. All right, so we are back in our beautiful underwater pavilion. I love it. And we can put some of this stuff away. But we needed the quartz glass, I think, if I recall correctly. This stuff right here. And let's get 12 more. We're out of glass. All right, good. So we're going to need... What are we missing? Glowstone. I have glowstone. It's fine. Let's also get some glass while we're here. Boom, 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 boom. Good. We'll put those away. That way we have them for later. And some glowstone. We need, 12? 12 of them, I think, is the magic number. We'll put all those away. Good. And good. Perfect. Okay, so that should give us our 316 case. Good. And now we can get ourselves the 64K unit right here. More glowstone. 4 more glowstone. 16 glowstone total. All right. Again, this is one of those things that we need to automate and get done up. So the storage drawer thing may happen because then we would have had access to all of this stuff and we would have been good to go already. And yeah, okay. Now I'm only making, that's only one of these. I wanted 3 of these 64Ks, and we might just do that, but for right now, we're going to go with just the 1. Yeah, and we're going to put one of these away. So this is going to be a six unit for right now until we set up a little bit better of a system down here. Now, I think we're already getting too crowded because of my terrible wiring and terrible mechanics of doing all this stuff here. And I think what we need to do is I need to hollow out a whole bunch of stuff here. I really wish that there was a hammer, like a tinker's hammer, but there's no tinkers. That would be nice. Anyways, we'll just pipe it out right here, just for right now. Clog this station up even more. It's fine. And then we're just going to do this. And no, we'll move this over by 1 block. Is that going to interfere? It kind of blocks the charger, but that's okay. And then we can remove those. And we can throw in our 64K. And that'll give us our crafting status, our auto crafting setup. Good. The next step that we need is to get ourselves a pattern. Blank patterns and stuff like that. So we need a whole bunch of those, but we're also going to need the pattern terminal here, which does require another crafting terminal, which I'm going to make right now. I think I actually maybe have everything except for the crafting table, right? Yeah, I think so. All but the crafting table. No big deal. Once we get this auto crafting up and running, it will greatly improve the overall feel. So there's our pattern terminal. Good. Now, where do I want to put that? That's a bit of a situation. I may change the way that these are, too. They might actually poke out or something like that. So maybe just right now, we'll run it right down here. Right alongside. So let's get that ME cable again. Just the one or two, I guess. See, this is going to look bad for right now. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. But it'll at least allow us to get things done. So there's our pattern table, our pattern terminal, sorry. And this is where we need the blank patterns for. So we need to get glowstone up and running, and I'd like to get a storage bus on it, actually. So for that, we need an ME interface and a storage bus. Good. Pros of having things already ready for you. All right, that'll go there. Priority 100 for right now. So now we have access to our glowstone, and now we should be able to make that blank pattern. Boom. Done. Okay, great. So we're going to make a couple of these, but before we even do that, we're going to make the blank pattern autocrafting recipe, right? So we're going to shift right click that in. That gives us the Certus, quartz glass, glowstone, and iron, and we're going to make that pattern a thing. All right, the next thing that we're probably going to need right away is the quartz glass. And for that, we're going to make a pattern as well, okay? Now, obviously, we're going to need to automate glass and Certus quartz dust down the road, but those are things that we can worry about a little bit later on. The other thing that we're going to need is we're going to need a few ME interfaces. So let's get a couple of those. Four? Not bad. That's a pretty good start. And a molecular assembler, or four. Let's get a few more of these. Four of those. Good. And go. I think we're going to need, yeah, we're going to need more cores. Okay. Not that one. This one. Formation core. Get. Oh, man. Last flux dust. Okay. Two is good enough for right now. I'm going to have to get more flux dust up and running, but that's a different story. So maybe we'll just use this same line right here. Yeah, that would probably work okay. I also want to get myself a wireless setup here so that I can access this stuff pretty much everywhere. So I think for right now, let's just go off the end here like so. And we will run... If we run that there, yeah, that'll work. That'll work. Okay, so that'll be there. That'll be there. Okay, and then we have this guy. No, not there. Okay, and let's see. If we do one in the middle, I guess, for right now, that'll work. And then these should all be powered, which they are. Good. Now we can actually put the patterns in here. And what will happen is it will use those molecular assemblers to make the patterns. So now if I look up blank patterns, you see a craft thing here. So I can actually say, okay, I need 100 of these. And it'll tell you what exactly you're missing. You're missing some Certus quartz crystal, you're missing glowstone dust, and Certus quartz dust to get that done. All right, so we could actually go, okay, I just need 10 now. Boom. And it'll start automatically crafting those for you. As you see, now we have 10 more blank patterns that we can use to our advantage. Very good. We can bring them on over to the pattern encoder here, and we can carry on and build out from there. So obviously, I need to get the drawer system up and running. So I think I'm going to set up some, I don't know if I'm going to do auto crafting for it, but there's certain things that you do want to auto craft for sure, like sticks, planks, all that kind of stuff. So I do want to get a lot of that going. We do have a lot of oak wood at the other base. So I am going to do the oak wood planks as a recipe. Good. And we'll just actually craft some up. And we want to know sticks. Good. All the basics is kind of what you want to get going. So then you want a crafting table. Good. You want a chest. So you're kind of getting all the basic fundamentals here of the oak planks, including the making of the oak planks themselves. All right. So this is pretty much the basic stuff. And then, you know, there's a few other things that you probably want to do as well that I'll probably just do off camera for the most part. But yeah, so let me check the time on the video. I feel like I've been talking about 20, 25 minutes now. So we might be at wrapping up point, but we'll find out here soon. This is all a mess. Again, I'm going to have to redo this entire basement. We need a lot more room, and we need it to be a lot more organized than what it is right now. But it's not too bad. I mean, the other option is we could maybe hang it up in the dome somewhere. That could be cool, too, instead of hiding it. Oh. Like, you know, we could, like, hang it as, like, a decorative thing. I don't know. We'll see. I got to come up with ideas there. All right. So one other thing that I wanted to do was automating the charge service because we're running out of Fluix dust and all that kind of stuff. So what I want to do is I want to automate the fact that we get the Certus quartz into the charger and then automatically output it into this drawer for right now. And again, this is probably going to move. So I'm just doing this right now as it lies so that we can get some of these basics up and running. And my full plan is to redo pretty much all of this before we get too far along or too big in down here. So anyways, this will be like this. So this will be charge Certus and it'll go in like that. Good. So automatically charge Certus will pull out. So let's get this upgraded so that we get our filter because we only want to pull out charged Certus, right? We don't want to pull out the regular Certus before it's charged. So then we're going to extract that as necessary. And what we should see here is one, and then this will be insert, boom, and we're up to two. And then this one, as soon as it charges, boom, it'll pull it out and we'll put in another one. Awesome. Now, I don't have this fully set up on a storage bus or anything like that, but I'm going to let these guys just run and automatically charge just by putting them into my system for right now. So, pretty straightforward way of doing things there, but we do need lots of charged Certus because we need to make more Fluix, and I want to wait until I get about a stack. I think a stack is a good number to go with, so I'm going to let this run. And we'll be back to make some Fluix because I need more Fluix dust so that we can carry on building and doing things. Now, the next thing that I want to do, though, is there's a compacting drawers in this. And I'd like to make quite a bit of these. Now, we are missing the stone, which we do have down here. And I was going to wait for a storage bus, but I think for right now, we're probably better off just going like this. That hole, though. Alright, so we'll just put that in there, and let's get ourselves the start of some compacting drawers. So that's 60. Ooh, should we go with 13 then? 13 of them? I think that's 60. Missing one! Really? Alright, 12. Good enough. Okay, so we'll get those crafted up, the compacting drawers. The glories of autocrafting. I love it. I absolutely love it. So this is going to house all of our major necessities. A big one right now being redstone, because apparently we're pretty much out of. It's fine. It's no big deal. So that'll be one of our first drawers that we implement in. I love EE3. The fact that I can just do that, what I just did, I just got myself 19 stacks of redstone because of our blaze farm. That's pretty darn awesome. All right, we're going to remove this guy. Let's see, are we lit anywhere? No. Okay, good. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to start placing down these drawers, just like so. I do need my locking key, and I'm going to start transferring things over to them. We're also going to need to make a drawer controller, but we'll get that right away. So for example, this iron is a perfect example of something that would go right here instead. Now, all that we'll do is we'll break this. Now, this one was storage bust. So, in the back here, all we're going to do is we're going to remove it, and we're going to place the storage bus. No, you know what? We're not going to do that right yet. No, we're not. We're not going to do that yet. I want to make the drawer controller. Indeed. And it's probably going to mess us up because we probably need that stuff. You know what? Okay, we'll do it temporarily. Temporarily, we're going to put it on here. That's so annoying. Okay, so we're going to put it on here for now. And we're going to hook it back up so that we have access to our iron, but we're going to make ourselves a drawer controller just to get this thing done and done quickly because, yeah, we need it. It's done. Okay, good. Drawer controller. Go. All right, so we don't have the redstone comparators, which means we don't have the redstone torches, which means we don't have the sticks, which we can autocraft. See, this is why you do autocrafting of sticks. Oh, yeah. All right, good. So we need 6 redstone torches. Good. We need a couple pieces of nether quartz. I'm just going to grab them out of our system right here, even though we have some downstairs. But we only need a couple, so not a big deal. And this is going to give us our comparator. 2 of them. Excellent. Oh, 1 of them, because we're out of stone. Really? 1, 2. Really, really? Okay. 2 comparators, good. So those will go in there like that. And then we need to get ourselves, is it just a regular drawer or can it be any drawer? Looks like 2x2s work. Does it have to be any other type? Yeah, so those work. Okay, so we just need some more stone. What, 5 more pieces? I think should do it. And that should give us our drawer controller. So, drawer controller, get. Oh, we need one of these. We need one of these. Autocrafting. Go. Yes, perfect. All right, drawer controller, get. Awesome. So, this guy now we can use to work with our storage buses. So, for example, I'm going to put it down just right there, right beside here. And now we can remove this and we can place it back over here. This is still going to have a priority of plus 100, like so. But what we should have access to still is our iron. So if we go in here, we still have access to our iron. Perfect. Amazing. So I'm going to transfer over more of these barrels into drawers, and we'll see where that leads us. All right, so we got enough charged certus and whatnot to make some more fluix, which is great. So we'll get all that fluix made. Good, good, good. It's like popping popcorn, but fluix. I do need to run over to the other base to get it pulverized up, which is another story altogether. But that's going to give us some of that. And as you can see, we've started compressing over. I moved my charged certus over. We don't have any of the painted stuff on me at the moment, but that is working. Now, the thing is that's going to take all of our regular certus and make it into charged, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. I believe they are interchangeable. So maybe that's something that we could even do, just have charged for everything. I'm pretty sure that is the case anyways. Let's just double check though. So yeah, it looks, can you use it for all the same stuff? I know you can use it for that. I know you can use it for, oh, that's fluid, gas, wireless booster. Okay. Maybe not everything then, eh? Might not be everything. I know you can use it for the Certus Quartz dust. Maybe not quite everything then. Yeah, we might need to keep both around. So the Certus, obviously the wrench, that doesn't matter. But the ME storage, I think, can only be regular. Oh, no. It can be charged as well. Okay. So what can we make that we can't make the other way? View cell, I don't care about. Blank pattern, we can do both, I believe. We can do both. The tools, I don't care about at all. And I'm pretty sure we can do that. So yeah, we can literally just make it all charged at this point in time. So we can just run it all through the charger and automatically pull it out. So this Certus Quartz, we won't even need, by theory. It could all just be charged Certus. And we'll just have to make sure that all of our recipes work accordingly. The rest of this, I do need one more compacting, probably for like the cobblestone. But as for the rest of this, it looks to me like we are good to go with just standard drawers of some type. I probably need to get more wood anyways. So I'm going to head on back to the other base. I'm going to pulverize up this Fluix crystals into the dust, or at least one set of them into the dust. I'll probably do both, and then we'll set up some more seeds to be made with the other one, and then we can get the rest of this all done. I think we're pretty good. And then I can start to actually... We need to build the room for the machines and for our mob spawns, but we're getting there. We're getting there very quickly, which is great. So we'll get that started. We will get... What else was I going to do again? Oh, dang. I forgot. I forgot what I was going to do already. We have 35,000 ender pearls. Oh, baby. And just think, we can get so many more. Hi, creeper. Yeah, I heard you. I heard you. Okay, so that's going to be like that. We'll get the charge going, which is good. And let's see, what else do we want to do here? I think that's about it. So, I'm going to... Oh, I needed more wood. That's right. Hi. Please don't blow up right in the middle of all my machines. Thank you. All right, so we're going to need some more wood and this dust. So, one last weird thing. I tried putting cobble in a compacting drawer, and it didn't work. Not sure if that's a bug or not, but anyways, that's fine. We just need to get ourselves an upgrade template here. Good. We have one. That's excellent. And I think I just want to go with, like, emerald. Can we just get a few emeralds? Because it's the biggest one that we can get, so why not just pull a few emeralds out and call it that? Because... That's going to work very nicely. We're also going to need a few more sticks. Good. And those go around like so. Oh, and I got it backwards, didn't I? Yep, I did. Perfect. Okay, so at least there's the one emerald upgrade. I'll probably automate that process down the road. But there we go. We've now upgraded our barrel for our cobblestone. And we are good to go. So we've practically replaced everything with... the drawer system, which is great. I do want to move the processors into the drawer system over here, which we should be able to easily do. Just a matter of still being able to pull the printed silicone out as necessary. But we should be able to put it right there like that, and this should be able to pull out all the things. Let's see. Is that filtered? It is. That's the redstone filter. That's just extract. Okay. I'm going to have to do a little bit of maintenance here on this system. So let's do this. Good. This will be a redstone filter in. Good. Okay. And this will be extract always active. Great. Okay. This will be... You know what? We could probably just do an in and out. Right, so insert is good, extract is going to be the printed silicone when necessary. Right, so this should all input the processors in and pull out the printed silicone at the same time. And it's all connected up through some measure with our terrible system. But they're now also in the system, which means we don't need this storage bus here anymore. Sweet. Love it. Saving on some resources and compacting things down a little bit more should help out in the long run. But there you have it. We have all of our resources in the system now. For the most part. For the most part, we have them all in here. And that's great. So outside of that, I need to basically get more glowstone. Yeah, we need more glowstone. We need more of pretty much all the materials, which is basically just going to be me inputting lots of EMC and pulling out lots of different things. So I'm just going to pull out some glowstone, for example, and we can now just throw it directly into the system here or on the ground, whichever you prefer. I recommend in the system, and that should automatically input it into our compacting drawer here. And now we have ourselves 5 stacks and a bit of glowstone. Perfect. And dust, whatever that is, times 4. So good. Other than that, we're doing very well across the board. We do need to get more blank patterns. And the problem that we're having there is the Certus. Need to get more dust operational. So I need to get more dust done. But that's going to be it for this video. I know, a Minecraft video, right? Look at me go. Couple days off playing some fun games, and maybe I'm back. I don't know. I'll play as I play, And you'll start to see some other games prop up here soon. All of my tests went very well with the other games and how I want to play them and, you know, kind of perform them type thing. So it's great to hear. I hope you guys like them. And I'll see you next time. Slap that like button. Bye-bye for now.